Welcome to our video tutorial on import shipments. We'll show you how to create an import shipment and receive the cargo in your Magaya system. You can create an import shipment in several different ways. You can use the shipment wizards to create consolidations and straight shipments for air, ocean, and ground. You can also create a shipment manually by going to any shipment folder, such as air, ocean, or ground, right-clicking on the folder, and then adding your shipments there. You can also create a shipment from a quotation by going to the Actions menu and then clicking on Create Shipment, or by going to the Bookings area, then clicking the Actions button and creating a shipment from there. Whether you create a shipment from a quotation or a booking using this feature, you'll be able to create direct shipments, back-to-backs, and even add a quotation and a booking into a master that's already in the system. For example, if I click on Create Shipment, I'll select my commodities, click OK. If I click on this option, it will create a master and a house for me. Or if I leave it unchecked and continue, I can select the documents for the shipment. And in the final stage, we can find our folder, for example, air. And if we select the folder, we create a direct shipment, or we can select the master that's already in the system and create a house within that master. We'll cancel this for this video, but if you're using the wizard, click Finish. From trip schedules, you can select your trip, and you can also create a shipment by going to Actions and creating the shipment from there. The last and most powerful option is receiving a shipment electronically via the Magaya Network from a forwarding agent. We'll go through this example during this video. In this video, we're going to use a shipment that was received via the Magaya Network from a forwarding agent. All shipments received are within the inbox of the Magaya Network. Also, if you go to Maintenance, then Configuration, and click on Incoming Messages, you can configure the options for incoming shipments, and including whether the charges or entities should be saved. So let's go into our Received Electronically folder, and here we have the master with the master documentation, and the house with the house documentation. You may or may not need to create your master, but a master shipment is needed for back-to-back and consolidations in order to maintain shipment integrity. This means if you have a house, you'll need to have the master as well. Data entry for import shipments usually consists of the General tab, the Entities tab, the Routing tab, the Charges tab, the Delivery tab, and the Commodities section. So now we're going to see how to do an import shipment reception. There's two ways to do this, and it all depends on whether you have a warehouse or not. If you don't have a warehouse, you can click the Actions button and just use these three statuses here. You can also use the Events tab for more statuses. The second option is if you have a warehouse or need to create warehouse receipts. This is called the shipment reception process. Notice in this case, we did the shipment reception from the master in order to receive all the houses. Over here, the issued by is my company with the employee, and we can also set a default location to receive the goods. In this example, we'll choose this location, and we have the option to create a warehouse receipt per house shipment, and also use a house shipment Weibo number as the warehouse receipt number. If it's ocean or ground, this will be the bill of lading number, and for air, the air Weibo number. Now let's click the Receive button and carry out the reception process. Notice my cargo is automatically on hand, and we can click this button to go to the warehouse receipt. Here we have the warehouse receipt. If we go back to the master, we can see the shipment status is received. This also applies to the houses. If we go to the house shipment events, we can see that we have new events. You can notify your customers via email by sending a tracking link. Also under maintenance configuration, you have your event definitions. Each of these events can also be triggered to send a transaction tracking email. For the United States, we have several US customs integrations. If we click the customs menu, first, we have an automated manifest system for sending flight and vessel departure messages before they arrive in the US. Second, we have ISF for ocean imports. Ocean shipment data must be sent to US Customs at least 24 hours prior to the loading of the vessel at the foreign port. And then lastly, we have an automated broker interface. This is used for customs brokerage. Now let's take a quick moment to review the shipment list. This is found under Warehousing and then clicking Shipment List. In here, you can see the status of each shipment. If you click the Actions button, you have access to shipment reports, and container reports. Now we're going to show you three easy steps in order to customize the shipment list. First, go to Actions, and then choose your columns. Second, select your predefined dates, or do a filter, such as Standard or Advanced. And third, click here to save this view. Name your view, click OK, and now you can select your view at any time. Be sure to check out the knowledge base for step-by-step articles you can print or email to help you use the software fully. Thanks for watching.